جتنی بھی دنیاوی ضروریات ہیں، پیدائش سے لے کر موت تک ان کو پورا کرنے کے لیے مختلف وسیلے ہمیں درکار ہوتے ہیں۔ جس طرح جسمانی ضروریات کے لیے وسیلہ ضروری ہے، اسی طرح اللہ تعالیٰ کا عرفان اور اللہ تعالیٰ کا قرب حاصل کرنے کے لیے وسیلے کی انتہائی ضرورت ہے۔ قرآن و حدیث کی روشنی میں انہوں نے اس کو بڑے ہی خوبصورت انداز میں ڈچ زبان میں واضح کیا، اور انہوں نے یہ فرمایا کہ قرآن کی آیات کو ہم سمجھ سکتے ہیں، حدیث تو ہم استاد سے سمجھ سکتے ہیں، لیکن جو یزکیہم ہے، یعنی نفس امارہ سے نفس لمامہ اور اس کے بعد نفس مطمئنہ تک جانے کے لیے ہمیں ان روحانی شخصیتوں کی ہستی کی قرآن و حدیث کی روشنی میں وسیلہ بنانے کی اور ڈھونڈنے کی ضرورت ہے۔ اللہ تعالیٰ ہمیں مشائخ کا احترام کرنے کی توفیق عطا فرمائے۔ اب آپ کے سامنے قبلہ پیر صاحب کے ساتھ برطانیہ سے تشریف لائے ہوئے نوجوان مبلغ، جو کہ انگلش زبان میں اپنے بیان کو پیش کرتے ہیں، جناب حضرت مولانا حافظ محمد بلال صاحب قادری نوشہری مدظ اللہ العالی، ان کو میں اسٹیج پر دعوت دینے جا رہا ہوں۔ نعرہ کے ساتھ ان کا استقبال فرمائے، نعرہ تکبیر، نعرہ رسالت، نعرہ حیدری، نعرہ غوثیہ، مبلغ اسلام، غوث پاک، فخر نوشاہی، علماء اہل سنت۔
الحمد لله، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين، أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. واجعل لي وزيرا من اهلي هارون اخي اشدده ازري.
سبحان الله ما شاء الله.
صدق الله مولانا العظيم. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: الا وان في الجسد مضغه اذا صلحت صلح الجسد كله، وَإِذَا فَسَدَتْ فَسَدَ الْجَسَدُ كُلُّهُ،
سبحان اللہ،
الا وهي القلب،
سبحان اللہ، ما شاء اللہ۔
قال اللہ تبارک و تعالی فی شان حبیبه المغفر و مغامرا: ان اللہ و ملائکته یصلون علی النبی، یا ایوہ الذین آمنوا صلوا علیہ وسلموا تسلیما، اللہم صلی علی سیدنا و مولانا محمد مبارک وسلم وسلم علیہ، سلام و سلام علیك يا سيدي يا رسول الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا حبيب الله. مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم محمد سيد القومين والثقلين والفريقين من عرب ومن عجم، ثم الرضا عن أبي بكر وعن عمر وعن علي وعن عثمان ذي الكرم. يا رب بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم. After trying to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and reciting a holy verse from the holy Quran, the only true words of Allah azza wa jal, and then after sending salutation on the final beloved messenger of Allah Azza wa Jal, Hazrat Muhammad al-Mustafa, Ahmad al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his companions and his family. My respectable teacher, spiritual guidance, قبلہ پیر سید معروف حسین شاہ صاحب عارف قادری نوشہری دامت برکاتہم العالیہ، ریسپیکٹیبل علماء اینڈ آلسو the young generation lineage of as a Sayyid Haji Muhammad Musha Ganbash Qadri Rahmatullah Alayhi scholars, and I mean Sahibzada Sayyid Irfan Shah Sahib and Sahibzada Sayyid Safwan Shah Sahib, who are both two great Jews Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has gifted the Silsila Nushahiyya with in the time we are living in now. When I say that, why are they great Jews? Because the people of knowledge, those who distribute the teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, all of them are Jews. So, in this time and age, giving or conveying the true message of Allah Azza wa Jal and the teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the lives of the great saints and friends of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is difficult. We can have a lot of people gathered under the banner of the tasawwuf, under the banner of Sufism. Yet, they are far away from the teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yet they are far away from the reality of the tasawwuf. People have made it a joke. I'll come to that point later on in my speech. I'm honored once again coming in this mosque in Rotterdam. We travel with my Sheikh Tariqat every trip. Alhamdulillah, every second sitting with him increases my knowledge. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, اطلبوا العلم من المهدي الى الله. Seek knowledge from cradle to grave. Look at the teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's all we are here for. From the minute you are born till you enter the grave, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, gain knowledge. Knowledge of deen. Because that's the only knowledge that's gonna make us head towards paradise, salvation. The verse I have read, Qibla Sahibzada Sahib talk on a few subjects, and obviously people, you understand Dutch more because it's your mother tongue. Everybody appreciates and likes and enjoys their own mother tongue, what they understand. But alhamdulillah, there are some people who are from the Pakistan subcontinent, also some brothers have traveled from the United Kingdom just for the Urs. They made the effort. Two brothers, three brothers, they made the effort and drove from all the way to United Kingdom for no other purpose. For no other purpose. But to come in your masjid for the cause to understand deen and the tasawwuf. It's also a lesson for the brothers who live in this community. It's every individual person's duty in Rotterdam who live around this masjid. This mosque does not belong to Qibla Sheikh Tariqat. He doesn't own it. Neither do the people here representing it own it. Because the houses of worship for Allah Azza wa Jal are for Allah Azza wa Jal. That's why Allah says, in return, I am making your house in paradise. It's a place of worship. The door should be open for all. But as a community, the people living in Rotterdam, wake up. brothers. Death is just on our shoulders. Are you waiting for the time when Allah says, قُلْ يَتَوَفَّاكُمْ مَلَكُ الْمَوْتِ الَّذِي وُكِّلَ بِكُمْ ثُمَّ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ تُرْجَعُونَ. Say to them, the angel of death, he is appointed to take your soul. Are you waiting for that time so he comes and takes it? Do you not believe that everything is going to perish? Do you think these luxuries, everything we have around us, day in, day out, this is the life? When brothers come to reality, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying to us in the Quran, this is not the real life. It may revolve you. You might benefit for a limited time. You may eat food just to kill your starve and hunger. You may wear nice clothes when you're young to look young and beautiful. So you may get a good wife. You might want a good car and a good house. But brothers, all these luxurious things are temporary. A temporary. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the imam of all prophets, leader of all creation, blessed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, lived a simple, noble life. Islam did not come to us easy. Do you think Islam, the religion Islam, came to us just like this? No. Look at the sacrifices Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his companions did for us. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had to migrate from Mecca to Medina. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was stoned. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam entered the city of Taif. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, some children were sent after him, called him names, abused him physically and verbally. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was called mad. He was called a magician. Did not Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam take for us? What did not the sacrifices the companions do for the religion Islam? They gave up their homes, their children, their wealth. For what purpose? To preach the true, to convey the true message of Allah Azawajal and believing in one Allah and worshiping Him alone and practicing the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For who? For our salvation. That's why Allah says, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I only created jinn and human to worship me. We've got to face Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The sacrifices Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave his companions, and yet the Muslim Ummah, after 1400 more years down the line, what do we do? We can't even make the effort to fulfill the five basic duties of Islam. This is the Muslim Ummah, not just in Holland, anywhere. And then you know what thing? People will probably agree with me and they say, you know what? It's a sign of Qiyamah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam predicted this. There's no doubt in that. But why are you trying to become part of the sign of Qiyamah? If you know that's the sign of the Qiyamah, these things are going to occur, why not stay restrained from them?
Subhanallah.
Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam migrated from Mecca to Medina. And you know how hard it was? No, we don't. I only traveled on coach 8 hours from Mecca to Medina. I was exhausted. I had AC in the car, food and water. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam just went with one of his companions, Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu, in hot weather. No water, no food, no transport. Just one camel.
Subhanallah.
You think it's easy? No. Islam came to us with those great personalities, those great people, the great prophets, sacrifices. That's why Islam reached to us today.
Subhanallah.
So coming to the point, brothers, don't look at specific or individuals that this person is from this tariqah, this person is from this tariqah. Yes, we are no shahi, alhamdulillah, because that's where we've got our share of knowledge and spirituality from. For brothers, a masjid does not belong to one tariqah. A masjid is for open all Muslims or even non-Muslims. It's a place of worship. People of Rotterdam, wake up, brothers. It's every individual's obligatory, it's compulsory on them to bring two or three or one friend at least with them to the masjid. Brothers, who else is going to do it? The Maulanas? Are we? We can only tell you, brother. People can come from different cities and deliver speech once a year, or maybe twice a year, or maybe once a week on a Friday. Isn't it the duty of all Muslims to participate in this? Yes, it is. The whole purpose of my speech today is to not always tell you, because you know it's a habitual. If you keep telling people about good things, good things, good things, and you don't keep a balance, they think, you know what, this is it, it's easy. Brother, it's not easy. Yes, reciting the poems of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is a blessing. Because all the Quran is a poem, it's praise Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Yes. No doubt in that. Yes, reading nuts is good. But remember, brothers, in the grave, you will not be asked a question. Did you recite not on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Do you go to the house? No. The first thing you will be asked about after the three questions, Man Rabbuka, Man Deenuka, and about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's prophecy, is going to be about your salah. It's gonna be about your salah. Jannat is there. Ticket for Jannat. In few points, have you heard it? Do you agree on me? Raise your hands if you agree with me so I know you're communicating with me. Jazakallah, that's what they say. That's true. But brothers, wake up. The only thing that for salvation is the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and staying steadfast on your deen. I didn't realize my time is finishing, but because I recited a verse from the Holy Quran, and people are going to think he's reciting a verse of the Holy Quran, and what's that got to do with the topic, and the hadith is read. Maybe I can finish this in Dihe, but the verse I read, it was Waj'alni waziran min ahli Harun akhishtu bihi azri. It was related to the subject of seeking help other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, meaning i.e. from the Anbiya or the Awliya. And this one verse would have been some evidence towards the topic I chose, but I didn't realize. But maybe why I didn't get to say these things, I'm closing it now, because my time's up. Inshallah, I'll finish this topic while I started in Dihe, in Kaplanstad tomorrow, inshallah. But today, maybe, and I believe that this message that has been conveyed to you is to give you a wake-up call. It's to give you a wake-up call. And that's the blessing of Sheikh Hikmikat. Because the speech I memorized, I've never done a speech. Alhamdulillah, that's the sarufat. That is the first spirituality one can understand if they live pious people like that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if I have disheartened anybody in Rotterdam by saying some harsh things, but remember, truth is always bitter. Truth is always bitter. It's bitter. So maybe today you can go out of this masjid and think, yes, if you think it makes sense, we should strive to fulfill the duties of this masjid as a Muslim. Not just because you're a Shaykh, as a Muslim. May Allah give us the tawfiq. And I thank Haji Sir Francis and everybody for welcoming me. If I dishearten anybody's heart, please forgive me. And I ask forgiveness for this particular visa. And pray that Allah gives the visa a long life, healthy life. Make us steadfast on the deen. Remember, brothers.